Hello and welcome to Vision Academy. My name is Hanumant Ladva and in this video we are going to write a C program to find sum of even and odd numbers. Let us write the preprocessor directives hash include in angular brace we'll write standard input output dot h. The next preprocessor directive is hash include in angular brace we'll write console input output dot h header file. Now we'll write void main function curly open brace and here I'm going to declare all the necessary variable which are to be used in the program with its respective data type. Here I'm going to take integer and I'll take I, n and one more variable called osum, that is odd number sum is set to 0. Next esum, that is even number sum, is also set to 0. Now I'm going to write CLR SCR function. Now we'll ask the user to enter the number in a printf function. So in a double quotation mark, I'm going to write enter the number. End the double quotation mark and put semicolon. Now we are going to receive the value for n using scanf function from the user through keyboard. So here I'm going to write in a double quotation mark the format specifier percentage d that is associated with integer type of data. Next comma ampersand of will take this n variable. Now let us take looping structure for because we want to find the sum of natural even and odd numbers. For that I have to write I is equal to 1 because natural number starts from 1. That's the reason I have taken I is equal to 1. Now it has to iterate up to n. So I is less than or equal to n and put semicolon I plus plus curly open brace and here we are going to check the condition. So I'm going to write if I value modular division by 2 means what? If the I value is exactly divisible by 2 giving no remainder, that is 0 remainder, then it is even number, correct? Yes. So let us calculate the sum of even numbers using esum variable which we have used here. So esum is equal to esum plus I and put semicolon. If it is not, then else part. Here we are going to write O sum, that is odd sum, is equal to odd sum plus I and put semicolon. For this respective opening brace, we are going to put closing brace. Now let us print both of these sum and even odd numbers. So here sum of all even numbers in a printf statement in a double quotation mark I'm going to write sum of all even numbers is equal to percentage d backward slash n end the double quotation mark and then I'm going to write the sum of all even numbers stored in esum. Here we'll write esum variable and put semicolon. Next statement is printf in a double quotation mark I'm going to write sum of all odd numbers is equal to percentage d end the double quotation mark put comma and odd sum is stored in o sum. Here I'm going to write o sum close the bracket and put semicolon. Here I'm going to write get ch and then curly closing brace. Now let us see an example how exactly this program works. So here I'm going to write output. So once we compile and run this program, it will ask the user to enter the number. Here I'm going to write enter the number. For example, I'm going to enter 5. Here it is going to receive 5. So that is n value is 5. Here for I is equal to 1, 1 is less than or equal to n is 5. So 1 is less than or equal to 5. Condition is true. If this is true, then the control enters into the body of this for by executing these statement depending on the condition. If this is true. So for the first time I is what? 1. So 1 modular division by 2. Here if I say 1 modular division by 2, so 1 is less than 2. Here numerator is less than denominator, hence it is going to give us remainder 1. Quotient will become 0, which is not equal to 0, means it is false. If this condition is false, then this particular statement will not get executed. So control transfers to else part and it is going to perform O sum is equal to O sum plus I. So what will happen now? We'll write O sum is equal to, O sum is equated with the value 0 for the first time. Here we are going to write 0 plus I value is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So 1 is equated in O sum variable. Again control transfers to for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I value is 2. Next we are going to check this condition. If 2 is modular division by 2. So this gives us remainder 2 ones are 2 ones are. Here quotient is 1, remainder is what? 0. So 2 is exactly divisible by 2, hence it is leaving remainder 0. So if this is true, then E sum is equal to E sum plus I will be executed. So here E sum is equal to E sum is for the first time it is 0 plus I value is what? 2 is equal to. So 0 plus 2 gives me 2. So this value is stored in enum. Again, E sum. So again control transfers to for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I value is 3. Next we are going to check this condition. 3 modular division by 2. Whether it is going to give us 0 or 1. So here you can see 2 ones are 2 ones are. Remainder is 1, which is not equal to 0. Hence this particular statement will not get executed. Else part will get executed. Here it is going to perform O sum is equal to O sum value, earlier it was 1. Here I'll write 1 plus O sum I value is what? I value is 3. So 1 plus 3 is 4. So 4 is stored in O sum. Again control transfers to for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I value is 4. 4 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, condition is true. Again we are going to write 4 modular division by 2. Here it is exactly divisible by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 2s are 4. Remainder is what? 0. If this is true, then E sum will be performed. So E sum is equal to E sum plus I. E sum earlier it was 2 plus I value is now it is 4. So 2 plus 4 is 6. So 6 is stored in E sum. Again control transfers to for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I is 5. 5 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, condition is true. Next we are going to check this condition. 5, that is I value is 5 divided by 2. So here 2 ones are 2, 2s are 4, 1 is remainder. So it is going to leave 1, which is not equal to 0. Hence this condition is false. If this condition is false, then this statement will not get executed. The control transfers to else part and it is going to execute O sum is equal to O sum earlier. What the value? It consisting of value 4 plus I value is now 5 is equal to 4 plus 5 is 9. So 9 is stored in O sum. Again control transfers to for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I value is 6. Here 6 is less than or equal to 5. No, condition fails. Once the condition fails, the control comes out of the looping structure and it is going to execute the next statement. What it is going to print? It is going to print sum of all even numbers. Sum of all even numbers is equal to percentage D esum. So here esum is holding 6. Next we'll write sum of all odd numbers is equal to percentage D O sum. The last value of O sum was 9. Here I'll write 9. Here you can see I'll write the natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here this is odd number. Odd number, odd number. 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 5 is 9. So odd number sum is 5. So here even number is 2 and 4. 2 plus 4 is 6. So here the sum of all even numbers is 6. So let us execute this program. For that, I will take you to my laptop screen.
Here I have already written this program in Turbo C++ integrated development environment. Now we are going to compile this program by pressing Alt F9. Here it is showing success. There is no syntax error. I'm going to press enter. Now we are going to run this program by pressing Ctrl F9. Here it is asking the user to enter the number. For example, I'm going to enter 5 and I'm going to press enter. Here you can see the sum of all even numbers is equal to 6. So in between 1 to 5, we have got 2 and 4 are the even number. 2 plus 4 is 6. And in between 1 and 5, we have got 3 odd numbers. 1, 3 and 5. 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 plus 5 is 9. So sum of odd numbers is equal to 5. I hope you understood this program. If so, please write down in the comment box as understood. Thank you.